the Dunlop National Rally Championship.
Welcome once again to On The Limit Sports for round two of the Dunlop National Rally Championship, the Hillgrove Hotel Monaghan Stages Rally. As you can see behind me, the spectators have gathered in Park Fermi this morning, all ready to feast their eyes on the calibre of machinery here today, ready to tackle the nine stages. We've got 141 crews, and amongst that, a lot of local interest.
Everybody's nervous here this morning, so I know just nobody looking at the boys there and that, and they're just walking about and trying to eat their nails and mess about. But when you get out onto the first stage and get the first mile in and get in on it, it'll not be too bad, so not. But the main thing here today is getting your tyres right. If you get your tyres right, it's half the battle.
Declan Boyle won the battle at the opening round in Abbey Leaks, but since then the Donegal man crashed his Subaru at the Circuit of Kerry and was hoping for better luck at round two in Monaghan.
We're going to give it a good go. We're not looking to win it, but if we can come second or third or something like that, it'll keep us, and you know, keep us there in the championship.
Drawing lots of attention at Park Fermi was the Impreza S14 of Sam Moffat, who was making a very last minute step up to WRC for his local rally.
We're used to seeing you behind the wheel of a Mitsubishi today. It's an S14, it's left-hand drive, it's all new to you.
It is all new, and this happened at Saturday morning at 1 o'clock in the morning. Just basically had trouble with my own car on Friday evening, and if it hadn't been any other rally, I probably wouldn't have done the rally, but it's my local rally, and everyone's here, and it's a great rally, and there's a great entry, and fair play to Monaghan Motor Club. It is great stages as well, and I'll be happy to be out.
After his amazing win at last year's Monaghan Rally, Daniel McKenna went on to cap off a great year by winning the Billy Coleman Award. And the local man was back to compete as number one seed on his home rally.
Yeah, well, we've bigger fish to fry this year. Like, we're concentrating on the British Championship, but we said we'd come back to Monaghan and give it a go again. But it's a national round this year, and there's six or seven WRC cars, so we're delighted to get running number one on the road, but with the conditions the way they are, we decided that they were going to run behind the WRC cars and just concentrate on our only battle at the two-wheel drive class, you know, because there's enough pressure on the motor club without me maybe causing any hassle in front of the WRC cars, but we're looking forward to it now.
So with a stellar lineup of drivers and machinery that included the likes of Donna Kelly in the S11, tarmac champion Darren Gass also in an S11, and Dara O'Riordan in the Fiesta WRC, the stage was set for an epic contest over the 9-stage Hillgrove Hotel Monaghan Stages Rally. First on the road were championship leaders Declan and Brian Boyle. The Donegal cousins were quickest by 11 seconds on the first stage, despite some brake trouble in the S12. Second quickest on the next two, their lead was down to 5 seconds after stage 3.
Right down there. Four right, four left through the junction and through the bridge. 400 up the hill. Up in the Care Crest, go light, two right, deceptive, keep in.
Niall Maguire had gear selection trouble in his older S11, and the local man was fourth after the opening loop.
Got right over crest, keep it on her. 40, straight crest, okay, 100, one go. She came in. One right. right, with two left. Slide right after the bridge, go, you will live. Line for flat two right over crest, 80, flat right over crest, 100, straight crest, 160, in deep, to turn square right.
Donegal's Donna Kelly retired with engine trouble on stage two. Tarmac champion Darren Gass wasn't happy with his car settings or tyre choice on the opening loop. He held fifth place for the moment. In third place, Dara O'Riordan wasn't enjoying his second drive in his new Fiesta WRC. The Cork man was feeling very unwell and was considering pulling out of the event. In contrast, Sam Moffat was relishing his debut WRC drive, posting third quickest time on stage two and then quickest time on stage three, to lie just 5 seconds off rally leader Declan Boyle. Quickest two-wheel drive and fifth overall on stage one, last year's winner Daniel McKenna slid his escort off the road and out of the rally on stage two. Fellow Monaghan man Gary McPhillips wasn't happy with the suspension. On his mark two on the opening loop, he held ninth overall.
40, crested with jump, 170 to the top, turn square right. 100. Three left, 60, and towards square left.
One of the two-wheel drive favourites, James Stafford, was forced to retire his Darien after a stage one mishap. Frank Kelly had brake trouble and tyre issues on the opening loop and was just outside the top 10.
Everyone knew that the Monaghan Stages Rally was going to produce a fantastic Mark II escort battle, and it hasn't proven wrong.
Yeah, it's a ferocious battle. It's not that way. He's coming to Monaghan to try and race Mark II men in Monaghan, but we're having a good enough run. The stages are very unpredictable. Daniel got caught out in stage two, unfortunately. Gary's going really well. I think we're about six, maybe seven down on him at the minute. And there's quite a few of the class 13s going very hard. So we've took a wee bit of a gamble on tyres, gone a good bit harder on tyres, so hopefully the stages have cleaned up.
One of those Class 13 machines was the starlet of local man Richard Moffat, a cousin of Sam. Richard drove exceptionally well on the opening loop to hold seventh overall and led the two-wheel drive section. 19 seconds behind Moffat after three stages was Donegal's Declan Gallagher.
60 crest, flat left, 60 crest, flat left, on crest jump. 150, flat left, on crest jump, 150, turn square right.
Chris Armstrong showed some good early pace before eventually succumbing to the punishing Monaghan jumps on stage two.
Keep right into two left over dip, plus tight, 40, press and jump mid 80, press and jump into one right minus long, tightens, 300, turn square left, repeat turn square left, and chicane over crossroads, bus stop, repeat crossroads, bus stop.
Welsh visitor James Belton felt a calendar would have been more useful to measure his times on the first two stages, but he was happier with his drive over stage three. Roy White caught and passed Belton on stage one and was lying sixth overall in his MGS 2000 after the opening loop. After a final stage accident in the Carrick Forest Rally, Josh Moffat was understandably cautious on the opening loop, but he still held second in Group N and 10th overall. Shane McGuire had switched from Subaru to Mitsubishi, but gear trouble forced his retirement on stage one. Another early local retirement was the misfiring Evo 9 of Stephen Wright, whose forest rallying background was evident at this stage one junction. Quickest in Group N after the opening loop was Donegal crew Martin Doherty and Damien McAuley, who held eighth going into the first service hall. Holding the overall lead despite some worrying brake trouble was fellow Donegal man Declan Boyle.
Halfway into it, the brakes seemed to get very soft, the pedal got very soft, and when we came off the stage then, you know, the pedal just wasn't right. But I think it's down to all of the braking that we were doing on stage one. So we'll get it looked at here now, and stage three it acted the same. So hopefully it'll not be too bad.
Well, everyone knew this was going to be an all-new challenge for you, Sam, and you've really surprised us on the times this morning.
Surprised myself. Just couldn't believe it. Got into the car and down into a square right, and I just says, geez, this thing can stop. And from there, I just didn't look back. I just said, it just feels like a PlayStation, and she just wants you to drive it, and it's great. Again, a few big moments in stage two. I just had to settle myself, but it's... Words can't describe how good it is, especially coming from a Group N car. It is just so good.
So far today, we've seen a display of firsts from the Monaghan man, Sam Moffat. First time behind the wheel of a WRC, first time in left-hand drive. Can he take his first national win this evening? We'll find out on the final loop of stages.
The Dunlop National Rally Championship. Welcome back to Monaghan for part two of the Hillgrove Hotel Monaghan Stages Rally. Passes through stage four were rally leaders Declan and Brian Boyle. The Donegal men had fitted their Impreza S12 with slick tyres, but as is so often the case with Irish weather, clear skies can turn to rain in the blink of an eye. The stage five downpour left the roads treacherous, as the Boyle cousins found out when they slid their Subaru off the road, losing over 5 minutes and the rally lead. While some were more prepared for rain than others, Sam Moffat was also on dry weather tyres, but showed great maturity to guide his S14 through the loop and into the rally lead. Niall McGuire's experience saw him get through the loop without any major drama, as the local man climbed to third overall.
Body, flat crest, body, flat crest and jump 100. Straight flat crest, keep it lip. 300 down, go on. Well, stop you can, okay.
Darren Gass and Jerick McMonagall retired with mechanical trouble on stage four. Still feeling very ill, Dara O'Riordan showed admirable determination to stay going and climbed up to second place in his Fiesta WRC. After a torrid opening loop that left him outside the top 10, James Belton excelled in the wet conditions to climb to fourth overall. Roy White mounted a bank on stage six and broke a drive shaft in his Rover MG, but he managed to nurse it to service area while slipping to eighth overall. Frank Kelly threw caution to the wind once the stages dried out again and climbed to fifth overall and into the two-wheel drive lead. Local crew Gary McPhillips and Mark Tierney had been ahead of Kelly up until stage six, when alternator trouble brought a halt to their drive. Back at the service area, Declan Boyle's Subaru was looking decidedly second-hand after his stage five off.
Is the rumour true? Was it as easy as reaching for the wipers?
It was. Just reach for the wipers between a square left and another square left, but no distance. Just put my head down and flicked the wiper switch, and I had the cut on it, but for some reason, with the water and everything else and the lack of concentration, the car just crossed the road into a big hedge. We reversed back out of it again, but we hung around because the boot lid was hanging off and Niall was coming, and then Brian had to run around the corner to watch the other drivers coming. So with all of that, we lost, I don't know, 5 or 6 or 7 minutes. Another one of them days.
There's still a lot of work to do and still a lot of learning, but we're happy to keep going as it is. If the rally was over now, I'd be very happy.
Not wanting to repeat the mistakes of the middle loop, crews were busy making cuts in the tyres for the last loop. But it wasn't tyres that troubled Class 13 leader Declan Gallagher.
So just about holding on to that lead at the moment, Declan, but problems in your camp now too.
Aye, a few problems there now with a bad misfire there. it seems to come and go in the car, you know. But I were enjoying it now. It was tricky in that first one out of service because everybody was in hard selection. It just rained halfway through it. Like, it's very tricky, but we'll have to try and keep it steady and hopefully we boys can get the misfire sorted.
Everyone is watching closely the battle between yourself and Declan Gallagher. He's got problems now. It may be your chance to take this class lead.
Yeah, well, we were going, we had a good run in the first loop this morning, and then after service there, the rain came on the stage and the screen seemed up fully and we couldn't see at all, and he took 40 seconds of us. So after that again, we had two decent runs and we took a little bit back. So I think it's around 14 or 15 he has now. So we'll have a go and see what happens.
With points up for grabs in both the Dunlop National and the Sligo Pallets Border Championship, we turn to the class winners now for the final loop. And taking the win in Class 1 were local crew Francie McKenna and Sean Craig in the Rover MG. Donegal crew Mark Boyle and Charles Gallagher won Class 2 in their Honda Civic. The Civic Type R of fellow Donegal crew Mark Ewing and John Egan took victory in Class 3. Class 6 featured action from the Citroën C2 Cup, and after taking an early lead, Galway's Stephen Greeny and Keith McHugh crashed out of the rally on Stage 3. Welsh driver Steve Woods, with navigator Keith Moriarty, took over the lead until a Stage 6 puncture demoted them to second place, behind Class 6 winners Sean Agnew and Peter Deary, who took maximum points in the opening round of the Citroën C2 Cup. Tommy Doyle and Lee Monaghan recovered well from a Stage 3 spin to take the Class 7 win and finish 13th overall in the Renault Clio. Wicklow's Lloyd Hutchinson won Class 9 and finished 20th overall, with navigator Willie Fitzpatrick another class trophy won at a canter in the Austin Mini. Local crew John and Niall Kelly won Class 10 in the Toyota Corolla. In Class 11, it was another home win in a Corolla for Seamus Connolly and Gary McCrudden, who maintained their joint lead of the Sligo Pallets Border Championship with fellow Monaghan crew and defending border champions Arthur and Matt Kearns, who took the top spot in Class 12 and finished 17th overall. Liam Bohan and Damien Connolly had been vying for the top spot in Class 13, but earlier mechanical trouble meant they had to settle for 6th in Class and 18th overall. 5th in Class 13 and 16th overall went to more locals, Raymond Conlon and Darren McCaig. Cabin crew Russell Woods and Gary Gallagher took 4th in Class 13 and 14th overall. Fellow cabin crew and defending Class 13 champions Jonathan Pringle and Martin Byrne finished 12th overall and 3rd in the two-wheel drive class. 17 seconds quicker in 11th were local crew Richard Moffat and Martin Connolly, who had to settle for 2nd in the two-wheel drive battle, just 7.4 seconds behind class winners Declan Gallagher and Ronan Murren from Donegal, who finished 10th overall in the Toyota Starlet.
Definitely the Monaghan men put it up to you today, Declan, but I'm sure victory is tasting sweet coming from Donegal and beating them at their own game on their own soil.
Aye, well, I don't think we'd have bit Richard Moffat, only afraid we were a problem there in the middle of the day, like, but in fairness, it was an enjoyable rally and there were brilliant stages and very well run event, like, so it was very enjoyable and we had a good day.
The day was going very well for Frank Kelly and Liam Brennan, who were 5th overall and leading the two-wheel drive class up to the very last stage, where they unfortunately slid into a field and out of the rally. Another non-finisher worth a mention in Class 14 was local man Paddy O'Reilly, who entertained his home fans in his usual style before retiring on Stage 4.
One left of the fence, keep on that, Paddy, one left of the fence now. Give her that 60 after it. 60 after it for two right. Go on. And turn hairpin left. A wee neck. That's the job.
Oh, yeah, bad.
Paddy. 170. Two right, long pass, three left.
Class 15 was won by more locals, Michael Tynan and Derek Mackerel, in the Evo 6. Kevin Eaves finished second junior at the Carrick Forestry Rally, driving a C2 R2. And he followed that up with the junior win in Monaghan in his regular mount, the Toyota Corolla. Stanley Orr and Brian Cairns won the historic class in their Mark 1 Escort. Johnny Leonard and Niall Burns brought their Evo 6 to second in Class 20 and 15th overall, and also took the Dunlop Drive of the Day award.
A fantastic drive by you today, a productive one, but also great to get this award by Dunlop.
Yeah, it's great to get the award. We're still really learning the car because we only have it there for a couple of months. So this is the third event, but the first stage event. So we have a lot to learn yet, but we seem to be taking to it all right.
Back to the overall battle now, and doing well to salvage a ninth place finish after their earlier off were Donegal cousins Declan and Brian Boyle. A late surge by Paddy McVeigh and Stephen O'Hanlon saw the Dungannon crew climb into the top 10 to finish 8th overall. Local man Josh Moffat with co-driver John Roan pushed hard on the last loop to try for the Group N win, but they had to settle for 2nd in class and 7th overall. Just 3.4 seconds behind Group N winners Martin Doherty and Damon McCauley from Donegal, who finished 6th overall. With the broken drive shaft fixed at service, Roy White led his Rover off the leash for the final loop. He won Class 20 and finished 5th overall with navigator James O'Brien. James Belton and Mark Glenister couldn't improve on 4th place over the final loop, but they got to bring the Class 8 trophy back home to Wales. Having felt sick all day, Cork's Dara O'Riordan was glad to see the finish line as he finished 3rd overall with co-driver Tony McDade. 7-time winner of the Monaghan stages, Niall Maguire had to settle for the runner-up spot this time on his home rally, as he and co-driver Enda Sherry finished over a minute behind fellow Monaghan crew Sam Moffat and James O'Reilly. It was a day of firsts for the 22-year-old Sam. First time in a WRC, first time in a left-hand drive car, and now his first ever outright win, as he made the step up to WRC machinery seem like a breeze.
Well, your home crowd are very happy to welcome you in as winner of the Monaghan Stages Rally 2013. Certainly when I spoke to you this morning, it wasn't a result you expected. Quite a nerve-wracking day for you.
Yeah, I was just hoping I wasn't going to get beaten by Josh or something, you know, but the car never missed a beat all day. Fair play to McKinstry on such a short notice, and just can't believe I'm here.
Well, the result may not have sunk in yet with Sam, but there's confirmation of the fantastic win, which moves him up to 3rd on the points table.
Back at the Hillgrove Hotel this evening, the crowds are out in force to welcome their winner here, Sam Moffat, co-driven by James O'Reilly. An incredible drive by him today. Niall Maguire, the Monaghan man, also takes 2nd place. We'll see what happens at the next round in Cavan in a few weeks' time. See you then.